This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Ral Partha Enterprises, Inc. of Cincinnati, Ohio produces miniature figures in 25 FASA in 1998, and was one of the assets acquired by WizKids in 2000. The following year, Ral Partha's production assets were recast as Iron Wind Metals, LLC of Cincinnati, a company which continues to produce many of the Ral Partha lines of miniatures. In 2015, and the 40th anniversary of the founding of Ral Partha, Iron Wind Metals reacquired the long unused trademarks and relaunched Ral Partha as a division of the company focused on producing archived miniature lines under the banner of the Chaos Wars Gaming World Contents 1 licensees and distributors 11 United States, 12 Canada, 13 Great Britain, 14 Continental Europe, 15 Australia, 2 product codes, 3 company history, 31 Basement Enterprise, 1975-1978-32 producer of signature lines, 1979-1986-33 Chaos Wars, 1986-1987. 34 producer of licensed lines, 1988-1995-35 The Trouble with Wizards, 1996-2001-36 Iron Wind Metals, 2001-2014-37 Ral Partha, a division of Iron Wind Metals, 2014 present 4 sculptors, artists and mold makers 5 awards 6 references in popular culture 7 notes 71 footnotes 72 citations 8 external links licensees and distributors United States in 1980 Ral Partha licensed select designs to Rockcliffe Pewter, a longtime producer of cast metal art. The pewter versions of Ral Partha sculpts were typically bare metal with a satin finish and decorated with glass jewels in time. A division of the company called Partha Pewter was established to produce directly for the giftware market. Canada Ral Partha established a licensing agreement with RAFM, a miniatures manufacturer in Paris, Ontario, Canada in 1980. The two companies have had a long-term working relationship which lasted well into the 1990s. Great Britain in 1979 Citadel Miniatures was formed by Games Workshop as a miniatures production shop to produce their own figures and to distribute Ral Partha figures in Britain. Citadel Miniatures attempted to establish a U.S. division in 1982 with Ral Partha as the local manufacturer. The partnership was short-lived, and in 1984 Games Workshop established their own U.S. subsidiary and became a direct competitor. The Citadel Miniatures U.S. products were brought under the Ral Partha logo and marketed as Ral Partha Imports in 1985. The import lines included the FTXXX Fantasy Tribes, FaxXX Fantasy Adventurer, FF31XXX Fiend Factory, FS32XX Fantasy Special, the popular WFXX Weird Fantasy Series with whimsical themes, FMMXX Fantasy Mysterious Miniatures, and LBXX Tabletops Laser Burn line of Space Marines. Historical lines included Romans RXX, Dark Ages DAXX, Medievals MXXX and Samurai Sam XX. At least 2 figures FTT3 Troll Hurling Rock and FTT4 Troll in Chainmail with Scimitar were sculpted by Tom Meier while visiting England in 1981. Indiana 1986, Minifigs gained the rights to manufacture and distribute Ral Partha's fantasy range. In Britain the following year Ral Partha dropped Citadel Miniatures historical lines and began to distribute Denizen Miniatures Dwarves 33XXX, Orcs 34XXX, 36XXX Legion of the Damned Skeletons, and 39XXX Fantastic Adventurers Continental Europe. By 1989, that Judecart of Paris gained the rights to distribute Ral Partha figures in Continental Europe. Some early Ral Partha advertisements erroneously give the name as Judecart. The relationship was ongoing in 1997, but was probably severed when FASA purchased Ral Partha the following year. Australia in the 1980s and 1990s Australia, Ral Partha products were distributed by Military Simulations of Moorabbin, Victoria and then Bentley, Victoria product codes only. A product code marked Ral Partha's early packaging and customers required a contemporary catalogue in order to identify the miniature. In late 1979 the company switched from product product codes that used descriptive letter and number codes to a numeric system. For example, in the series Personalities and Things That Go Bump in the Night, ES001 Evil Wizard, casting spell became 01001, and the first figure of the 15th century Renaissance series 1501 command set became 54001. The change was not universal. Ral Partha used letter codes for Citadel Miniatures and Denizen Miniatures in their line of Ral Partha imports until 1992. Ral Partha's international partners used their own systems. RAFM of Canada used the descriptive product codes as late as 1984. Jeu Descartes initially used Ral Partha's numeric codes on packaging of their own design, but new lines were introduced selectively and given codes sequential to their own series as a result. Product codes often differ depending on whether the miniatures were produced in the United States, Canada, or Europe. Throughout the company's history, figures were modified to improve reproducibility, unpopular designs were re-sculpted, and existing product codes were used for new designs. A common cause of modification was a level of detail or animation which challenged the casting technology and industry-wide reorientation of scale from 25. Catalogs in 1985 and 1996, a 2000 direct mail catalog, and sporadically released updated order forms which listed all the figures in production in the late 1996. Ral Partha augmented their catalogs with a webpage which highlighted popular products and new releases. After the formation of Iron Wind Metals in 2001, an online catalog and electronic order forms entirely replaced printed catalogs. Company history. Ral Partha Enterprises was formed in 1975. When Glenn E. Kidd, Tom Meier and Rich Smethurst set out to produce Meier's sculptures. Meier pioneered the sculpture of miniatures in a two-part epoxy putty designed for automotive repair. The epoxy held detail better than traditional media, and rest of the miniature industry adopted its use when mixed together. The blue and yellow components of the putty formed a green putty which gave rise to the term greens for the original artist's work. Finding themselves still short of funds, the three enlisted Mark Rubin, Chuck Crane, and Jack Hesselbrock as partners. The six investors pooled $3,000 to purchase the equipment necessary to produce Meier's sculptures. The company had its origins in the established hobby of historical war gaming, but the company's rapid growth was fostered by the popularity of role-playing games. The company was named after Ral Partha, a particularly successful wizard character created by Tom's young friend John Winkler. The character was a notoriously hard bargainer whose shrewdness was exemplified by the catchphrase, "What's it worth to you?" It was hoped that the fledgling company would have similar good fortune like their popular line of three-stage characters. Ral Partha has had a trio of aspects. The first was a Winkler's gaming character, depicted as ES001 Evil Wizard, casting spell Ral. Winkler himself became one of the company's chief casters. Lastly, Ral was the company's totemic progenitor, credited with collaborative projects and depicted as 10-412. Lord of the Balrog's products were originally cast in the basement of 3642 Hyde Park Avenue, in the Fairfax neighborhood of Cincinnati, the home of the company's first president, Glenn E. Kidd. In the spring of 1978, the company established a factory at 3726 Lonsdale Street in the Norwood section of Cincinnati. At the time of the move, the address was erroneously rendered as 2732 and 2736 Lonsdale, but there is number 2700 block of that street. Small stickers were applied to the 1978 product catalog to correct the address. Those stickers have typically fallen off in the intervening years. By November 1980, Ral Partha moved to a larger industrial space at 5938 Carthage Court, where it, and the Iron Wind Metals production facilities remained until 2014. Iron Wind Metals has its offices and production facilities at 10437 Chester Road in Woodlawn, Ohio. Ral Partha's formative years were the late 1970s, when the company was a part-time basement enterprise producing the art of a teenage sculptor for a nascent gaming market. In 1979, the company became a full-time endeavor with industrial space and two professional sculptors designing products for multiple themes made popular by the rapidly expanding gaming market. The number of sculptors and catalog of miniatures grew rapidly in the mid-1980s. The preponderance of work moved from Ral Partha's sculptors' designs to manufacturing under license for nationally marketed games in the short run. The move was economically beneficial, however, the lack of product diversity left the company vulnerable to the marketing decisions of clients for whom room miniatures were a minor interest between 2001 and 2014. Ral Partha was an unused trademark caught up in the mergers and intellectual property negotiations between large game producers since 2001. The focus of Iron Wind Metals has been on existing product lines, BattleTech licensed figures, and manufacturing for partner companies who carry out their own designs, marketing, and distribution. In 2014, the production and productive capacities were reunited under Ral Partha Enterprises, a division of Iron Wind Metals Basement Enterprise. 1975-1978. The young company received early encouragement from the sale of its entire stock at Gen Con 1976, a convention of gaming enthusiasts. Ral Partha's lines and customer base grew quickly, and they regularly won multiple categories of the Origins Award. Ral Partha's figures were popular with historical wargamers, but fans of fantasy-themed role-playing games like TSR Inc.'s Dungeons. Greater detail than many of his contemporaries, but some early products presented challenges to the casting process. One of Tom Meier's earliest lines was the Fantasy line, which included about 24 figures in late 1976. Meier's ES-18 Adventuress is credited as being the first female character for role-playing games. The Fantasy line was renamed S-01XXX Personalities and Things That Go Bump in the Night in 1978, and Meier augmented the line throughout the 1980s as early as 1976. Meier had begun a series of soldiers from classical antiquity which were collected together as an 35XXX the Hoplites. By 1978 the line was essentially complete and included Greeks, Carthaginians, Persians, Gauls, early Republic Romans and Macedonians. Another series begun by Meier in 1976 was a line of 11th century knights and footmen called 1142XXX 1200 AD. The series included Vikings, English, French, Spanish, Moorish, Mongol, and Sung Chinese soldiers. Ral Partha put EXXX Wizards, Warriors and Warlocks into production in 1976, 1977, and 1979. The line included some of Meier's earliest work and much of it was executed in the style of Heritage Models, for whom he had briefly worked. The EXXX series was retired in 1980, but portions of it were re-released in 1995 as part of the 19XXX Ral Partha Remembered line commemorating the company's 20th anniversary. In 1978 Ral Partha acquired the Old Guard's Legions of the Petal Throne line of figures for TSR Inc.'s Empire of the Petal Throne, a role-playing game based on M.A.R. Barker's World of Tecumel. Ral Partha retained the services of William Murray, the line sculptor. Tom Meier and Brian Apple made contributions to the series T, Y, P, M, NHXXX in 1979, but it was discontinued later that year. As early as 1978, Ral Partha produced three series of 15. Producer of signature lines, 1979-1986. In the summer of 1978, Meier began reworking the themes of the EXXX series to create the CS-02XXX Fantasy Collectors line of elves. Meier's lines were successful and he began sculpting full-time in 1979. The addition of dwarves in 1979 and goblins in 1980 almost entirely replaced the EXXX series. Meier added halflings in 1982 and began a series of fantasy vehicles. The first was 02-030 Dwarf Steam Cannon, released in 1983. Meier's contribution to the series was completed when 02-078 the War Machine and 02-020 the Elf Chariot were put into production in 1984. Ral Partha hired Dennis Mize in 1979 with two full-time sculptors. Ral Partha's product lines increased rapidly. Mize's first project was HXXX Royal Armies of the Hyborian Age to accompany a Fantasy Games Unlimited game of the same name, based on the world of Robert E. Howard's Conan the Barbarian. The Hyborian line was dropped in 1980, and Mize introduced 53-7XX the Samurai and a line of 15mm fantasy soldiers called 05XXX Armies of Myth and Legend. His popular CN 13XXX Children of the Night was begun by 1982 and expanded over the course of the next 2 years. In 1982, Mize and Meier created figures for small thematic box sets called 98XXX The Adventurer's Mize. Mize also added to and revised Meier's The Hoplites and 1200 AD lines in 1984. In 1979, Meier introduced 15 54 XXX Conda Titeri, a line of Renaissance-era figures. The First offerings were imperialists, to which he added Swiss and Turks in 1980. Meier expanded the historical ranges with the 1983 edition of 88XXX. The colonial sculpts for the Anglo-Zulu War were augmented in 1984 with figures for the Northwest Frontier and the Sudan Campaign. In 1985, Ral Partha entered the game market in 1980 with the release of 99001 Witch's Cauldron, 99002 Caverns Deep, 99003 Final Frontier, and 99004 Galactic Grenadier. Skirmish games designed by Glenn E. Kidd and Mark Rubin, Galactic Grenadier, included miniatures from the GGXXX Series 15. Questions, scenarios for battles with Ral Partha figures, and new releases by Ral Partha and those which they distributed for RAFM. The Partha pipeline continued for 3 more years until ending its first series in 1986. A second series using the same name would be revived in 1999. Julie Guthrie began freelance sculpting for Ral Partha in 1983. Her first line was the O2-9XX All Things Dark and Dangerous. She worked with Meier and Mize on 98XXX The Adventurers later that year, box sets of 10-3XX The Best of Ral Partha and Julie Guthrie's 96XXX ElfQuest figures for Chasosium's ElfQuest game were put into production. Guthrie expanded the All Things Dark and Dangerous line in 1984, 1985, and 1986. In 1984 she joined Meier and Mize to develop a short series of miniatures 95XXX for Nova Games' Lost World series of combat books. In 1985 Guthrie contributed two sculpts of unicorns to PO3XX Once Upon a Time series designed for the giftware market, cast in lead-free alloy, and marketed as Partha Pewter by Rockliffe Pewter. Their work with Pewter allowed Ral Partha's mold makers to develop the technical expertise necessary to transition to non-lead alloys. In the early 1990s, Robert N. Charette joined Ral Partha in 1984 and contributed to Meier's The Hoplites, 1200 AD, and CS-02XXX Collector Series lines in 1985. Charette inaugurated figures for Chaosium's RuneQuest and a line of pulp adventurers. The line was initially called 20th Century Plus, but was later renamed 20XXX The Roaring Twenties. Charette revisited a line of figures he sculpted in 1979 to accompany Fantasy Games Unlimited's Gangster. Charette updated the line to include new cinematic themes such as The Intrepid Archaeologist. In 1986 Charette introduced 53-9XX Bushido, a line of miniatures for Bushido, a game he authored, and sculpted a line of figures for Fantasy Games Unlimited. In 1985, Bob Charette began producing a line of miniature robot war machines for a game that was first called Battledroids and renamed Battletech in 1986. For FASA's game of the same name, it was the beginning of a permanent relationship between the two companies that would eventually lead to Ral Partha's sale to FASA. Battletech products remain a leading product of Ral Partha's successor, Iron Wind Metals, and Charette continued on as creative development and authored several related novels. In 1986, Ral Partha sculptors crafted 01-3XX three-stage characters, which consisted of three aspects with increasing amounts of arms and armor to represent a single adventurer's game career. The line was folded into the S-01XXX line in 1987 because of their popularity with collectors and role players. They regained status as a separate line and a place of prominence in the 1991 and subsequent catalogs Chaos Wars, 1986-1987, at the same time that integrated campaign worlds like Games Workshop's Warhammer Fantasy Battle were showing early success. Ral Partha introduced the Chaos Wars theme into their 1986 and 1987 product lines. It was the first step toward unifying a collection of disparate themes into an integrated brand. In the 1986 catalog, sculptors were no longer credited, and a mythical Ral Partha rather than the president of the company addressed customers in the prologue. At about that same time, the Ral Partha staff had developed a 4-page rules according to Ral for medieval battles. A fantasy version by Bob Charette was released in 1987 as part of a boxed set rules according to Ral. Chaos Wars. The Chaos Wars theme collected together numerous existing products, many from Meier's S-01XXX line, and their packaging was marked with stickers as part of the Chaos Wars product line. The Partha Pipeline newsletter was transformed into the Ral Partha War Bulletin in January 1986. The War Bulletin followed much of the same format as the Pipeline, but its focus was the Chaos Wars product line release. increases were sporadic and continued until at least the spring of 1990. The new initiative was to include 10-2XX free companies of Chaos Wars box sets, but large contracts to produce miniatures for other gaming companies became a higher priority, and the Chaos Wars lines were appended to the CS-02XXX Collector's Series. Among these sets were Charette's popular Fangs of Fury Beastmen, Tom Meier's Korg's Killers Orcs, and Meier's Starbro Select Elves. Having never fully materialized, the Chaos Wars theme was set aside in 1988 in order to give necessary attention to producing official miniatures for TSR, Inc.'s Advanced Dungeons. Garrity, and Jim Johnson in 1992, and Cheese Fitzpatrick and Jeff Valley by 1995. By 1991, the 20XXX Battletech line had grown to include 11 box sets, and more than 100 mechs, aerospace fighters, and ground vehicles. Ral Partha also produced 25. Alloys. Ral Partha's staff had previously developed a lead-free alloy for their Partha Pewter, a line of collectible figurines designed for the giftware market. In September 1993, they began using a trademarked white metal alloy they called Rallidium in all their products, and its use marks a clear benchmark for dating old figures. The move away from lead was promoted in advertisements and bright red stickers on existing packaging in time. New York Governor Mario Cuomo relented to hobbyists' concerns and exempted miniatures from the state's public health law. However, the company never went back to lead. Ral Partha correctly anticipated the industry's movement away from lead, but the associated price increases came at a time when miniatures and role-playing games were being eclipsed by collectible card games like Wizards of the Coast's 1993 hit Magic: The Gathering. In 1994, the company experimented with Partha Plastics. The move was made well after Citadel Miniatures' successful introduction of plastic and part plastic figures, but the figures were not popular with Ral Partha's older customer base. In 1993, Dennis Mize designed the Titans of Terror series, which invoked the heroes and monsters of the horror films. The following year, Mize conceptualized and sculpted 017XX Beastmasters, a line of carnivores and their trainers. The line was expanded the following year, and would be completed until 1998. That same year, Ral Partha produced Coins of the Realm, fantasy and historical coinage. In 1995, Ral Partha's sculptors crafted figures for Steve Jackson Games' Space Knight, and dioramas called Sculptor's Row, the Sterling Collection, and Encounters of the Imagination: The Trouble with Wizards, 1996-2001. During Jack Hesselbrock's second term as company president, he re-established a newsletter which he called the Ral Partha Gaming Club. Like its predecessors, it addressed letters from customers and company news. The series ran for 6 issues from June 1996 to September 1997. In December of 1996, Ral Partha launched a website which hosted the newsletters and product ordering information. The newsletters reveal a number of licensing setbacks. The hobby market had moved away from role-playing games and wargames and was rapidly becoming dominated by collectible card games like Wizards of the Coast's Magic: The Gathering. Ral Partha faced a number of licensing setbacks. Steve Jackson Games' Ogre Miniatures and all three White Wolf lines were discontinued in 1996. Bob Charette's 18XXX RuneQuest figures were discontinued the following year. Since the late 1970s, the gaming miniatures industry had undergone what collectors call scale creep, an increase in size from 20 and 25. Response to the shift in the market, Ral Partha began adding to Tom Meier's Collector's Series CS-02XXX with a 30. Became the majority of Ral Partha's revenue under threat of also losing those lines and the financial difficulties created by the changing hobby market. The owners of Ral Partha sold the company in 1998 to FASA and Lanier Hurdle and Mike Hurdle, owners of Zoki Distribution, a hobby shop supplier. FASA gained sole ownership in the spring of 1999, and Ral Partha began to produce miniatures for FASA's Crimson Skies, Crucible, Conquest of the Final Realm, and VOR, the Maelstrom Games. No sooner were these miniatures in stores when FASA ceased production of all their games. In December 1999, Ral Partha launched the Partha Pipeline to announce new products for FASA's games, as well as house designs. At this time, Ral Partha had an in-house design studio and a host of staff and freelance sculptors, which included Kev Adams, Jeff Grace, Beryl W. Hubba III, Randy Kerr, Robert Kide, Phil Lewis, Dennis Mize, Bob Ollie, Tim Prow, Steve Saunders, C. Staples, Dave Summers, Jeff Wilhelm, John Winter. The second series of the Partha pipeline ran util late 2000 when the Ral Partha assets faced another acquisition in January 2001. WizKids, a New Jersey-based producer of plastic collectible miniatures games, acquired the bulk of Ral Partha's assets as part of their purchase of FASA's Battletech and Shadowrun games. WizKids purchased the rights to some figures from Ral Partha sculptors, but the bulk reverted to the artists. Meier retained his 15 1/54 XXX Conditeitary, 88 XXX The Colonials, and most of the CS02XXX Fantasy Collectors lines. Charette remained in possession of his 53-9XX Bushido figures. Ral Partha continued to produce miniatures for the Battletech and Shadowrun gaming worlds. WizKids licensed the rights to rulebooks and other gaming materials to Fantasy Productions, better known as FanPro, in the United States, which had produced and distributed the German-language versions of those games for FASA. FanPro's support of the Shadowrun and Battletech game worlds resulted in continued demand for metal miniatures by gaming enthusiasts. In March 2001, Ral Partha began producing collectible metal versions of the WizKids 64-figure Mage Knight Rebellion. Set the relationship between WizKids and Ral Partha was a short one. By year's end, WizKids rethought its investment in metal miniatures and divested itself of Ral Partha's manufacturing capabilities while retaining the Ral Partha trademark Iron Wind Metals. 2001-2014. In late 2001, Ral Partha's manufacturing capacities were spun off from WizKids, and renamed Iron Wind Metals, LLC, with longtime general manager Michael Noe as president and in partnership with Mark Rubin, one of Ral Partha's original owners. Iron Wind Metals retained the same location and much of the same production staff, molds, equipment, working relationships with artists, and licensing agreements in addition to their own lines. Iron Wind Metals carries out contract production work for other gaming labels such as Tom Myers' Thunderbolt Mountain, Dark Sword Miniatures, Crocodile Games, and dozens of others. Iron Wind Metals' new focus on productive capacities reflected a shift in game production strategy. The previous model had been that gaming companies hired sculptors and other creative talent to feed their in-house casting and packaging facilities. This model was successful, but artists sometimes didn't have the capital necessary to retain copyrights, and the mercurial nature of the market meant that their game designs could be sold to others, or languish as assets of a dead company. In the late 1980s, many game designers and sculptors established boutique companies, often operating out of their own homes, and then contracted out or made partnerships with companies like Iron Wind Metals to do the production. Iron Wind Metals continued to use the name Ral Partha to describe archived designs, but the website and Ral Partha trademark remained the property of WizKids, which underwent a series of acquisitions. In 2003, WizKids was purchased by Topps, a manufacturer of sports cards, who were interested in WizKids' range of similarly collectible plastic miniatures. In 2007, Topps was purchased by the Toronto Company, a private equity firm, citing falling profits associated with the Great Recession. Toronto put the WizKids product lines on hold in November 2008, but continued to lease the intellectual properties of Battletech and Shadowrun game worlds. In September 14, 2009, the Toronto Company sold the majority of the WizKids assets to the National Entertainment Collectibles Association, NECA, but retained the rights to Battletech, Shadowrun, and the Ral Partha trademark and website. The divisions and purchases meant that assets important to the Ral Partha brand were divided among numerous enterprises. Between 1998 and 2009, the Ral Partha trademark passed from FASA to WizKids, Topps, and finally the Toronto Company, none of whom utilized the brand. The miniatures for the Battletech miniatures produced by Ral Partha and then Iron Wind Metals remained popular, but the future of the game was always in question. FanPro had lost its bid to produce the Battletech and Shadowrun game worlds, but Inmediaires created a new subsidiary, Catalyst Game Labs, to design new expansions for the games and provided continuity by employing many former FanPro staff. The productive capacities for Ral Partha miniatures remained with Iron Wind Metals, who had retained working relationships with many of the artists, but could not use the Ral Partha name. Longtime customers could special order many of the figures, but they could not be marketed as Ral Partha figures. The trademark languished until until 2014 when the Tarante company agreed to sell the assets to Iron Wind Metals. By the end of 2014, Iron Wind Metals had recreated Ral Partha by forming a new division which united the Ral Partha trademark, website and sculptor's copyrights with their improved productive capacities. Ral Partha, a division of Iron Wind Metals, 2014 present on the 40th anniversary of the founding of Ral Partha, Iron Wind Metals relaunched the miniature lines from Ral Partha's Golden Age, establishing Ral Partha as a division of Iron Wind Metals. President Mike Noe and co-owner Mark Rubin launched a Kickstarter campaign to crowdfund the production costs of its 1980s lines under the Chaos Wars game World Rally. Partha had begun developing Chaos Wars in 1986. At that time they had released a new version of House Rules called Rules According to RAL Gaming System with scenarios, several boxed sets, and blister packs marked with Chaos Wars stickers. However, the initiative was put on hold by the push to produce miniatures for lines licensed by TSR, FASA, and other partners after a 16-year hiatus. Chaos Wars returned as a series of blister packs, limited edition boxed sets, and battle packs of elves, orcs and goblin figures drawn from Ral Partha's CS-02XXX Fantasy Collectors, 12XXX The All-American and other lines. A majority of the figures were sculpted by Tom Meier, who supported the re-release in 2016. Iron Wind Metals completed a second campaign and revived previously archived figures of dwarves, undead and troglodyte sculptors, artists and mold makers. Ral Partha's sculptors, artists, and mold makers and the years in which they worked for the company. Staff sculptors Tom Meier, 1975-1988, freelance 1989-1991, 2015-present Dennis Mize, 1979-1999 Julie Guthrie, 1983-1992. Bob Charette, 1984-1988 Chris Atkin, 1985-1999 Richard Kerr, 1987-1994 Sandra Garrity, 1988-1992 Dave Summers, 1988-1996 Bob Ollie, 1990-1999 Jeff Wilhelm, 1991-2000 Jim Johnson, 1992-1996 Steve Saunders, 1994-2001 Robert Kide, 1995-1996 Chris Fitzpatrick, 1995-2001 Jeff Valley, 1995-2001 Brady Bug, 1997-2001 Jeff Grace, 1997-2001 Kay Kersey, 1997-2001 Bobby Jackson, 1999-2001 John Winter, 1999-2001 Tim Prow, 2000-2001 James Van Schaik, 2000-2001 Freelance sculptors George Freeman, 1977-1978 Ann Gallup, 1977 William Murray, 1977-1978 Jay Adams, 1979 Brian Apple, 1979 Chubb Pearson, 1987 Nicholas Bibby, 1990 John M. Garrity, 1991 Walter B. Vale, 1991 Mold Makers, casters and production managers Michael Murphy, Mold Maker, production manager 1977-1986 Gary Wilkerson, Master Mold Maker 1977-1984 Michael Noe, Mold Maker 1982-1986, Production Manager 1987-2001, President 2001-present Brad Gorby, Illustrator, Sculptor, Mold Warrior 1984-1985 Brian Hitzman, Master Mold Maker 1984-1991. John Sarver, Master Mold Maker 1992-2001 Graphic Artists and Illustrators William Neff, Illustrator 1986-1987 Keith Holmes, Illustrator 1986 Douglas Mize, Illustrator 1987 Thomas O. Miller, Creative Director, 1988-1994 Michael Weaver, Art Director, Illustrator 1987-1990 Brian LeBrandi, Catalog Layout 1995-1997 Yaw DeCambra, Catalog Layout 1995-1997 Joseph Kide, Orthographic Design, Battletech 1995-2001 Awards Origins Awards, H.G. Wells Awards 1977 Best Fantasy Figure Series S-01XXX Fantasy Line Tom Meier 1978 Best Historical Figure Series 1142XXX 1200 AD Tom Meier 1978 Best Fantasy or Science Fiction Figure Series Fantasy Collectors Series CS-02XXX Tom Meier 1979 Best Fantasy or Science Fiction Figure Series Collectibles CS-02XXX Tom Meier 1980 Best Historical Figure Series, Condottieri 15/54 XXX. Tom Meier 1980 Best Fantasy or Science Fiction Figure Series, Personalities S01XXX. Tom Meier 1981 Best Historical Figure Series, Condottieri 15/54 XXX. Tom Meier 1982 Best Fantasy or Science Fiction Figure Series, Personalities. 1988 Best Fantasy or Science Fiction Figure Series, TSRZD. Mize 1992 Best Vehicular Miniatures Series, Battletech Mechs. Crane, Chris Atkin, Jim Johnson, Robert Kide, Dave Summers, Jeff Wilhelm. Origins Hall of Fame 1991 Tom Meier 1995 Julie Guthrie 1997 Ral Partha Battletech Mechs. The company was honored by the writers of the television show Andromeda by the naming of a fictional planet, Ral Parthia, a planet-wide nature preserve created by an ancient race of space aliens. The miniature company's name has been adopted by the San Francisco Scandinavian Preppy band Ral Partha Vogelbacher. Reportedly the last part of the band's name was the surname of a childhood bully of one of the members, and forms a statement of the nerd pride movement. Notes footnotes carrot unless otherwise noted, the designs discussed were produced in 25mm scale citations carat ABCDE hanging out warriors carat white dwarf magazine number 11 February March 1979 carat citadel compendium 1 games workshop 1984 carat ABRAL Partha advertisement dragon magazine number 82 February 1984 carat citadel miniatures US 1983 catalog carat ABRAL Partha enterprises Inc 1984 imports catalog carat ABCRAL Partha enterprises Inc 1985 historical catalog carat White Dwarf magazine number 24 April May 1981 carat history of miniature figurine production accessed December 7th 2008 carat ABCDERAL Partha Enterprises Inc 1987 catalog carat through the looking glass by Robert Bigelow Dragon magazine number 144 page 73 carat ABCDEFRAL Partha Enterprises Inc 1991 catalog Carat ABCDERAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1997 Catalog Carat ABCDEFGHIJRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1978 Catalog Carat ABCDEFGHRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1979 Catalog Carat ABCDEFGHIRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1980 Catalog Carat ABCDRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1992 Catalog Carat AFM advertisement in Dragon magazine number 90, October 1984 Tom Meier biography by Karen Meier, accessed November 23, 2008 AB The Courier volume 1 number 4, December 1980 The Courier interviews Glenn Kidd, by Dick Bryant, editor AB Cincinnati magazine Best Buys Choose Your Demons by Yanni Gardiner May 1978 pages 58-59 AB CRAL Partha Gaming Club newsletter Issue number 1 June 30, 1996 Carat ABCDEFGHIJRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1986 Catalog Carat ABCDRAL Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine number 4, March 1977 Carat RAL Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine number 16, July 1978 Carat RAL Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine number 43, November 1980 Carat ABRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 2000 Catalog Carat ABCDEF, Origins Game Fair, accessed November 24, 2008 Carat AB Wargaming World, Dragon Magazine No. 3, October 1976 Carat from the Fantasy Forge, Dragon Magazine No. 8, July 1977 Carat ABCDEFRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1982 Catalog Carat ABCDEFGRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1983 Catalog Carat ABCDEFGHIJRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1984 Catalog Carat ABCDERAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1985 Fantasy Catalog Carat RAL Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine No. 11, December 1977 Carat, Tom Meier on Thunderbolt Mountain Miniatures Forums, December 3, 2008 Carat, Strike Team Alpha, Board Game Geek accessed December November 22, 2008 Carrot Games Workshop Advertisement, White Dwarf Magazine No. 13, June-July 1979 Carrot Ral Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine No. 19, October 1978 Carrot Ral Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine No. 49, May 1981 Carrot, Fortress, at Board Game Geek Carrot The Partha Pipeline, Ral Partha Enterprises, First Series. Volume 1 No. 3, Fall 1983 Carrot ABRAL Partha Enterprises, Inc. 1983 Christmas Catalog Carrot RAL Partha Advertisement, Dragon Magazine No. 93, January 1985 Carrot Report on Origins 79, Dragon Magazine No. 29, September 1979 Carrot AB, Mirror of FGU Website, accessed December 17, 2008 Carrot Molten Magic in White Dwarf No. 14, August-September 1979 Carrot ABC, Bob Charette Games, accessed November 23, 2008 Carrot, Board Game Geek, RAL Partha Games, accessed November 24, 2008 Carrot, TMP, Chaos Wars, accessed November 23, 2008 Carrot The RAL Partha War Bulletin, RAL Partha Enterprises, Spring 1990 Carrot, Interview with Sandra Garrity, accessed November 24.